U.S. South Korea delay military exercises after Trump says tough stance on North Korea led to talks. U.S. Defense Secretary Jim Mattis said the drill would be conducted after the Pyeongchang Winter Paralympics, which will be held March 8 to 18 following the February 9 to 25 Olympics. In a possible opening for diplomacy, the Trump administration on Thursday agreed to delay joint military exercises with South Korea until after the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics. The decision could help reduce tensions as the Koreas consider holding their first direct talks in 2 years, even though Defense Secretary Jim Mattis insisted the delay was a practical necessity to accommodate the Olympics, not a political gesture. Mattis said the drill would be conducted sometime after the Winter Paralympics, which will be held March 8 to 18 following the February 9 to 25 Olympic Games. "For us, it is a practical matter," Mattis told journalists in an impromptu encounter at the Pentagon, citing the wide array of logistics and transportation support required to conduct the Olympics, some of which would otherwise be tied up with military exercises. The White House said President Donald Trump approved the postponement in consultation with South Korean President Moon Jae-in. It said the delay will allow U.S. and South Korean forces to focus on ensuring the security of the Games. The agreement delays a set of annual military exercises known as Full Eagle, which normally are held between February and April. Full Eagle is a series of exercises designed to test the readiness of the two countries' militaries. North Korea routinely objects to such maneuvers as a rehearsal for an invasion, and there had been fears that tensions could interfere with the Games occurring about 50 miles south of the heavily militarized border. For the first time in months, high-level diplomatic action between North and South is taking place. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un recently reopened a key cross-border communication channel with South Korea that had been dormant since February 2016, and the neighbors are exploring the possibility of a formal dialogue. Asked whether delaying the military maneuvers was a quid pro quo in response to Kim's reopening of cross-border communications, Mattis said, "No. Those talks are clearly the result of the amount of international pressure on North Korea, and they are a way for North Korea to start talking while keeping it contained to a benign issue." Later he said, "In terms of whether it is a one-off gesture from him or a real olive branch, I don't know." He said there can be little doubt that international pressure, including sanctions ordered by the UN Security Council, is having some effect on Kim's calculations. North Korea also has expressed interest in sending a delegation to participate in the Olympics. Although the decision was announced Thursday, the idea of delaying the military exercises had been under quiet discussion for weeks. U.S. officials had understood the South Korean military would be heavily committed to providing logistical support for the Games. Joseon Inchoni, president of the Plowshares Fund, which advocates for nuclear disarmament, wrote in a tweet that the delay is a welcome move to lessen hostilities after Trump's latest tweets about the size of his nuclear button. Surin Choni wrote, "Korean leaders have convinced him to take a step back from the brink." In a tweet early Thursday, Trump claimed his tough stance on nuclear weapons on the Korean Peninsula is help,